Back when I was a kid, my family had a quarry in the Lake Lahontan area in western Nevada. It had flagstone. It was out in the desert, and it was a flat desert land surrounded by hills, and the flagstone was up in the hills over 10,000 square acres. I would take the company Jeep to the hills, and I would take it to the base of the hill. I'd unload three or four pallets, and I'd drag them up the hill. And for each and every pallet full of flagstone that I could make, I'd drag it up to a flat spot, stack it up 4 foot by 4 foot, wrap the whole thing in chicken wire and put a tag on it. I'd get $8. And that was good money, actually, when I was 11 years old. And it was a cool job. I like being surrounded by the rough and tumble workers. I like being able to drive the company Jeep, and I like making good money. I was allowed to do 4 pallets a day, so I'd make $32 by the end of the day. And since we didn't have any babysitters up there in the desert in western Nevada, since most of my valued coworkers were on work release from jail, at night when the fellas would go out, my stepdad would drop me off at the Ormsby House Casino in Carson City, Nevada, and I'd spend my $32 playing keno for $1 a hand and drinking all the Roy Rogers that I could suck down. It was definitely a different world back when I was 11 years old than it is now. But one thing that hasn't changed is the Jeep is still the single best off-road vehicle made in the entire world. And the most desirable and most well-built of all those Jeeps is the Jeep Rubicon. Due west of Lake Lahontan in western Nevada is Lake Tahoe, and due west of Lake Tahoe is the Rubicon Trail. The Rubicon Trail is a 22-mile trail that is, whether famous or infamous, it is the supreme torture test for off-road vehicles in all of North America. And even a standard or even a well-equipped Jeep will have a very, very difficult time getting through the Rubicon Trail. So special interests and custom-made vehicles are built to perform that trail. The Rubicon is Jeep's factory version of what it takes to be the absolute best, and the Rubicon has always been the absolute best. One thing you'll notice about the Rubicon, whether new or old, this is a 2018 model Rubicon, is whether there's graphics that indicate it's a Rubicon or not, there's one way to tell for sure if it's a Rubicon, and that's right here. This looks like it's made out of plastic, but this is actually heavy-duty steel. This is made for climbing over 20-ton boulders and the vehicle getting high-centered. Well, that would devastate a traditional 4x4, but this is built to crawl over that extremely difficult terrain. Let's pop the hood and take a look at what's underneath. Now, a carryover from the 2017 model, the 2018 is all new, is the factory Pentastar 3.6-liter engine. Still puts out 285 horsepower, 260 pound-feet of torque. The prior model is known internally as the JK. The 2018 and newer models are known as the JL. This could be had with one of two transmissions, an ISIN-sourced 6-speed, which is one of my favorite transmissions in the world, or the new 50 Series Torque Flight 8-speed automatic, which is what this truck comes with, and that is also a really nice transmission. Looking around, every single thing about this truck you're going to notice is extraordinarily heavy duty. This isn't something with a bunch of plastic doohickeys that make it look like it's ready to go off-road. This is the real deal right out of the box. If you've ever driven in a situation, whether on-road or off-road, where you went through some pretty deep water and you see 6, 8, 10 inches of water and you think to yourself, you know, if I go through that, I could destroy my truck, because if water gets into your air filter, it gets into your engine. That concept is called vapor lock, and your engine is done if that ever happens. So don't ever drive through deep water just because you see somebody else doing it. The Rubicon has almost 11 inches of ground clearance at its lowest point. So right off the bat, you have fabulous clearance over weird terrain, but it can drive through 30 inches of water right off of the showroom floor without putting a snorkel on top, without making any modifications of any kind. Taking a look around, Well, this has the NV series transfer case, the Rock Track transfer case, and it's one of the best transfer cases for off-road use that there is in the world. It also has Dana 44 gears. It has 210 series in the front, 220 series in the back with a 410 final drive ratio. The Dana 44 axles, if you've ever heard that term before, believe it or not, that exact Dana 44 axle has been around for over 70 years. Let's take a look inside. Now, this is an unlimited. The unlimited means it has four doors instead of two doors. The wheelbase is over 20 inches longer on the unlimited over the two door, so it's a completely different driving experience, but it's a completely different experience for your passengers as well, since there's ample rear seat space. One giant problem on the unlimiteds is this latch right here. It is an absolute backbreaker if you're not paying attention getting in and out. But using your hand on it so you don't bump into it, you slide comfortably in here and you have all the space in the world. And so this top is painted to match or black. It comes one of two ways. It's called a Freedom top, and it's the most expensive top that you can get on a Jeep. And then this roll bar with integrated speakers is called the Jeep Sound Bar. And it's nice. This has the upgraded Alpine stereo sound system. So instead of eight speakers, it has an amplified nine speaker setup with an Alpine subwoofer in the back. Tons of headroom, tons of legroom, tons of room altogether. Really, really nice and comfortable. Taking a look in back, well, one thing you'll notice are the 33-inch tires on 17-inch alloy wheels. And so these are BF Goodrich KO2 all-terrains. They're made for Baja racing, as indicated on the tire itself, Baja Champion. One change for the 2018 and newer models is the rear camera itself. And so when you put the car in reverse, you have a great camera on the 8.4-inch monitor, and it's right in the middle of the wheel holding right there. The problem with that is a lot of people in this world like to get a spare tire case. That's just not going to happen on this model. If I open the back of the truck up, you're going to discover over 30 cubic feet of storage, even with the rear seats up. So to put that in perspective, if you took an E-Class Mercedes trunk, which is a big generous trunk, it would be more than double that. So lots and lots of space, over 70 cubic feet with the rear seats folded down. I mentioned that Alpine subwoofer. This is an all-weather subwoofer. Remember, this truck is designed for the windshield to be folded down, the Freedom top to be off, the doors to be removed, and you out there in the wilderness. And so you're rocking and rolling, but if water gets in here, your stereo system's ruined. Not the case here. This is an all-weather setup that's designed to be in the rain with the car completely stripped to nothing. Coming around the passenger side here, super, super nice looking. And so one of the main reasons people buy anything is just simply how it looks. And the Unlimited, particularly in the Rubicon model, is one of the best looking 4x4s on the road today. Let's jump back inside and turn it on. Leather interior, 8.4-inch Uconnect monitor. Let's turn it on. Now, despite it being a Jeep Wrangler, this is a rough and tumble truck. It's not designed to be quiet and smooth and precise, but it is. The 2018 and newer models, especially in the Unlimited model, have a very relaxed personality despite being built for the end of the world. There's absolutely nothing any factory truck can do in the world that this Jeep cannot do. It just does it with a great new stereo system. It has locking, what they call true lock locking differentials, with this toggle switch right here where I can lock the rear differential exclusively, or I can lock both the front and the rear differentials with one touch of a button. The front sway bar, I can actually disconnect that to allow greater articulation through ravines and such if I'm doing some really heavy duty stuff. It's painted to match interior accents all the way around. This is an absolutely beautiful, beautiful truck. And I'm the first to admit, if you're gonna do something that's built for the extremes of off-road use, like we have here on the Big Island of Hawaii, we're surrounded by Hualalai, Mauna Loa, Mauna Kea, with the observatories on top of the mountain. This is some of the most extreme driving that you'll ever experience anywhere in the world. The two most popular vehicles by far and away on the Big Island of Hawaii are four-wheel drive Toyotas and four-wheel drive Jeeps. However, you still, beyond going off-road and doing the daredevil things that you like to do in your four-wheel drive, need to drive this to work. You need to drive this to Costco. You need to drive it wherever you need to drive it. And if you're gonna have one car that's both a special interest car and a daily driver, I can't think of a better car in the world. Not Toyota, not Range Rover, not anything. The Rubicon is the real deal and one of the finest four-wheel drive vehicles of all time. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to reach out to me. My name's Joe Tunney. You can reach me at joelovesHawaii@gmail.com.